AI audiobooks? Seriously? Well, actually, I stumbled across this GitHub post a couple of days ago for StoryStorm, which is a combination of different AI technologies to generate a short story, to create an audiobook version of it, and even generate a cover image for it, all from within a single app. So let's see how that works, and let's see if it's actually doing what it says. Lucky for you guys, I have turned this into a template and also put it on the trending page. It's very, very easy to get to, but if it's not there at the moment, go and grab the link from the description. And we're gonna click on it and we're gonna see the Replit template version of this. Now you're gonna need to fork it first, and probably a good idea to make it private because we want the API keys to stay private. Now there are three API keys we need to give here. We need an OpenAI API key, we need an 11labs API key, and we need a replicate API key. All of these things are reasonably easy to get, and I'll show you where we're going for that now. Our OpenAI API key, as usual, can be found in the profile menu, and we'll grab that and copy it and paste it in here. So I'm gonna take the name OpenAI API key, and the value is gonna be pasted from the original location. I'm gonna add that. That key is the part that allows us to generate the actual story. The next thing we need to bring in is an 11labs key. Now, 11labs is a great place that allows AI generated voices, and they're really, really effective. If you get an account on the free plan, you can get a certain amount of text to speech for free, or if you fancy it, you can pay. But let's go in, make a free account, and get that API key. And we'll copy and paste that into the 11 API key secret. And again, just paste that value in the box below and click add. And we need one more. Now this is just to connect it to something like Stable Diffusion. Replicate allows us to run those models in the cloud. So we're gonna take an API key and bring that in as Replicate API token. Don't ask me why it's not a key. That's just what the requirements of the program needed. And we're gonna bring that in as well. Now with those three keys added, we can click run. It'll ask you if you wanna sign up, just press enter and that will give it a blank field and it'll start running and gathering its data. And what you end up with is this, which is our story generator. I'm gonna make that full screen so we can see what's going on. Now, of course, this is where the fun comes in. You get to generate your story based on a prompt of your choice. So let's start with a fun prompt from me. A magician grants the wish of the baldest man who works at Replit. I wonder who that could be. Now you pick a voice. I'm gonna leave it at the default and click submit. What it's going to go off and do is use GPT 3.5 to generate a story based on that. It's going to send that story then off to 11labs, generate the audio file and bring that back. And then it's going to use Stable Diffusion to generate the image. Now, as impressive as all this sounds, the stories are great. The image leaves a little bit to be desired, but we can't have everything, can we? Okay, so let's take a listen to that.
Once upon a time, there was a man who worked at Replit who was completely bald.
This story isn't a Mary Sue at all, is it? But that's pretty cool. Now, it's a 49-second story. It's great for a kid's bedtime story or something like that. But the potential of this is huge here. There's not a lot of code in this. Go fork it yourself. Go see the code. It is chaining together three separate AI APIs. And it's doing something remarkable. It is generating bespoke audiobooks that sound really, really good. We can even download this if we'd like and keep it for ourselves. I will just say the image is a little scary for this one, so maybe we might need to go into the code and adjust the prompts a little bit. But that's really cool. I mean, we've got the prompts here. If we were to change something, we could change this element here on line 41, which is saying the story text as the prompt for the image generation. If we add to that prompt, we wrap it with make a kid's storybook image, we get exactly what we want back. This idea of chaining together the different AIs seems to be working really, really well. And what we've got there really as an open source product could easily be commercialized and turned into something really, really powerful with some prompt engineering and some loving craft to the code. The new world of AI products is looking very exciting. Why not fork this on Replit and have a play with it for yourself and just see what sort of thing you can generate using minimal effort a maximum AI.